There goes in the paper.
Its task was well nigh superhuman, to organize, administer, supervise, and conduct our country's first wholly democratic elections. Many said it would be impossible, and it very nearly was. We had the will, but not the time.
And that man who oversaw the 1994 historic elections, the first democratic elections in South Africa as IEC chair, now retired Judge Johann Kriegle, joins us in studio. Hello and welcome. I'm Criselda Lewis. Now, 1994 was the year when many, especially black South Africans, cast their vote. Now, as momentum is building as we go towards South Africa's sixth and highly anticipated, highly contested elections, South Africans are pinning their hopes on the May 8th election, which carries hope of change. Change in how leaders of this country run it, and many are hoping to finally have access to many promises made at the dawn of democracy: water, sanitation, electricity, and much needed jobs. Let's welcome retired Judge Johann Kriegle. Judge, thank you very much for your time this evening.
It's a privilege and a pleasure to be here.
Thank you very much. Just taking a look at those visuals, it was a historic time in South Africa. You had to oversee the first democratic elections in this country. A mammoth task, a time where there was tremendous tension. Having a look at those visuals, what comes to mind?
First of all, I get goosebumps all over again. The tension was tremendous. The alternative was disaster. The six was the only option that we had. Of course, we realized that the time was too short to run proper, orderly, technically correct elections, but the decision had been taken elsewhere that we had to have the elections ready by the 27th of April, and the commission said, well, come hell or high water, we will be voting on the 27th of April. The main impression that I still have today is the elation of the people generally throughout the country that this day had come, and how long-suffering people had been waiting in queues but being much more enthusiastic than irritated. They wanted to vote and they were not going to be deterred by anything.
Well, South Africa, you know, at the time, people were willing to go through this democratic process. You know, it was necessary at the time, and it was also much about national unity. But how is South Africa 25 years later? Why does it still remain one of the most racially divided nations?
I'm not sure that I agree with that. Certainly we are very conscious of our racial differences, but that we are the most racially divided, I don't buy. I think we've come quite a long way in the last 25 years. There's been many disappointments, but there have also been many successes. I think that the evolution of a black middle class and incipient black middle class is one of our great achievements. Certainly the unemployment rate, particularly among the sub-30s, is very disturbing. Certainly the fact that there is the Gini factor, the difference, yes, between the haves and the have-nots, is as great as it was, is a grave disappointment and a concern. But I'm not downhearted, and I do believe that although there are very deep political divisions, by and large we still have the same general unity of purpose in South Africa.
I'll tell you, Judge Kriegle, why I say that is because 25 years on, there seems to be a growing anger amongst black South Africans. You've got a health system in the country that is near collapse. You've got one for the elite, you've got one for the poor. How many, after 25 years, can we say there are black-listed companies on the Johannesburg Securities Exchange? The education system, just recently, you also described as disappointing. We have children still falling into pit latrines in schools. What would you say to someone 25 years later, after you oversaw that crucial election, to somebody who says 25 years means nothing to me?
I would say, my brother or my sister or my son or my daughter, I understand your anger, I understand your impatience. We have not done as well as we should have, certainly not. Many of the dreams and expectations of that wonderful week of 1994 have not been met. I don't believe that we should look at our current situation in mutual recrimination, pointing fingers at one another. None of us has done as well as we should have. And I think we're going to go into these coming elections on the basis of selecting who will be best to catch up. We've somehow missed most of the opportunities in the last 10 years, particularly. I think there's consensus that they've been disastrous. There's an enormous catch-up job to be done, but that's not the only reason we lag behind. Mm. There are many reasons. You've mentioned health, education, transport, security, safety. These are all issues that should be looked at very, very seriously by the voters and ask themselves on the 8th of May, for whom am I going to vote in order to ensure that I have a government that is going to expedite what should have been done over the last 25 years and try to catch up?
I want to take a look at those voter numbers. I think it'll be very interesting to look at from the time when you were IEC chair to where we stand mm-hmm. as South Africa at the moment. If we could bring up that graphic that shows the registered voter turnout, I'm hoping it will come up on my right-hand side here. Well, that graphic, we don't seem to have it at this stage, but I think if we just look at the numbers, yes. Judge Kriegler, in 1999, for example, we had an 88% voter turnout.
Yes.
2004, 77. 77 again in 2009. In 2014, 73%.
Yes.
Does South Africa now face, for example, the risk, or are we there yet, of the voter losing confidence in this process because of a number of things? Corruption. I don't think in 1994 had we anticipated that these were the challenges that we would deal with today, where you've got South Africans who are saying, why should I vote? The looting is taking place. Let's look at the numbers. Talk to me about the numbers. Let's talk about 1994 right to 2014, where it seems there's been a decline in the number of people going to the vote. Perhaps one could argue, going to this election, we don't know. There might be those who might be disgruntled and say, what is the point?
You're perfectly correct, and the diminution in percentage turnout is a matter of note, not necessarily concern, because I think it's a universal experience that your percentages drop as the democracy settles down and becomes more comfortable.
Yeah.
But we should certainly be aiming for something over 80 this time round. The recent voter registration campaigns of the IEC.
Sorry, Judge Kriegle, let's have a look. I hope that we'll be able to bring it now. Here we go. The registered turnout, we'll get that up in a few seconds. Well, let's go back to that. We seem to be having a bit of a challenge, but please continue, Judge Kriegle.
I don't trust electronics ever. That's why I like voters filling in ballot papers by hand, not fancy machines.
Yes.
You can expect something just below 80% as is normal in a mature democracy. Mm. We should be grateful if we get that high. The voter registration was the point I was making. It wasn't as good as it could have been. The effort was there, but the turnout, particularly by the young people, wasn't.
Judge Kriegler, we'll chat a bit about that. I'm hoping we can get that graphic back after the break. Let's take a short break here on Unfiltered. We'll continue this discussion with the IEC chairperson back then in 1994, retired Judge Johann Kriegler. Stay with us.
Momentum. We're all born with it. No matter where life takes us, momentum protects us and repairs what's been damaged. Momentum Car Insurance gives you up to 30% cash back on your premiums every year, even if you claim. SMS CAR to 42024 or speak to your financial advisor for a quote. That's why we're here for you.
We've heard it many times from female entrepreneurs that they aren't taken seriously, and Future Females is a worldwide network of women.
So we're creating a platform where these women come and they collaborate and they meet each other.
Have the Civil Aviation Authority announced when they'll be making some announcement with regard to findings?
The Chief Executive Officer of Ethiopian Airlines, he said they do not even know the magnitude of the situation.
Bring us up to speed with regard to the latest developments.
We now know there was a football official, there was a journalist or a university professors.
Coco said his hands are clean and his detractors have ulterior motives.
South Africans have been sold a darling that Machela Coco had conflict of interest.
Our election website here on SABC is now live.
In a UN report, scientists say climate change is getting worse.
One third of our food sources for the population come out of the ocean.
We spoke to people who have been directly affected.
We have lost a lot of cattle. Gemsbok Vlakte, Toska, Gebied and Jakalskop. Everywhere you will see there's animals dying.
I've lost two of my cattle this January.
Africa's demand for clean drinking water is rising.
Drinking water is a top priority.
The next day when the water comes back, it's dirty.
I have implemented a level 5 water restriction, effective immediately.
Environmentalist seek solution to preserve the planet.
This is a Cape Kirpa, which is also one of the endemic species that is only found within the Western Cape, so it occurs nowhere else in the world except in our water system.
We've heard it many times from female entrepreneurs that they aren't taken seriously, and Future Females is a worldwide network of women.
So we're creating a platform where these women come and they collaborate and they meet each other.
Have the Civil Aviation Authority announced when they'll be making some announcement with regard to findings?
The Chief Executive Officer of Ethiopian Airlines, he said they do not even know the magnitude of the situation.
Bring us up to speed with regard to the latest developments.
We now know there was a football official, there was a journalist or a university professors.
Coco said his hands are clean and his detractors have ulterior motives.
South Africans have been sold a darling that Machela Coco had conflict of interest.
Our election website here on SABC is now live.
Hello again and welcome back to Unfiltered. Thank you very much for joining us this Sunday evening. We're chatting to the man who was at the helm of the Independent Electoral Commission in 1994, retired Judge Johann Kriegler. He still joins us. Thank you so much for staying with us, Judge Kriegler. I think let's bring up, that graphic that we have. If you look at in 1994, the number of contesting parties were 19. Let's move to the next one. In the following elections, we had 16 in 1999 contesting parties. We moved to the next one in 2004, 21. 2009, 26. 2014, 29. What I'd like to ask Judge Kriegler is that, I'll come back to that particular issue, but I wanted to know whether South Africa faces the risk of people losing confidence in this process because of a number of issues. I spoke before we went to the break about issues relating to corruption, for example, where it seemed like there'd been a declining number of people going to the polls for whatever reasons, probably scientifically, that would need to be proven. Mm-hmm. But South Africa could possibly run the risk of people thinking, it doesn't change anything.
Yes.
All right.
No, that certainly a loss of confidence in the democratic process, a loss of confidence in the possibility of the state to deliver that which Joe and Joan in the street want to have is a risk that is always run. I don't think we're in a serious risk generally. I do think that there is a fairly significant segment of the electorate, particularly the youngsters, that are disaffected with the process. Yes, it's the job of the political parties, particularly, to enthuse those, to try to make them appreciate that the country is their country as well, the government is their government as well, and that it is their right and their responsibility to ensure that the right people are elected to govern us for the next 5 years. That's a heavy job.
Yeah. The right people to govern this country. That brings me to my next question. Is it a lack of not producing the proper leadership, or the current leadership, or is there a complete lack of leadership that we're seeing in South Africa?
You know, you're speaking to the wrong person. An old person is always inclined to look at the people of their youth as the great, the leaders, the remarkable people. Certainly we do not have people of the stature of Madiba today. But there are leaders of substance, a general diminution in the importance of the big man is good in democracies. You must be voting for the party, for the party's principles, for its promised program, not for a particular person whom you happen to like. Mm-hmm. You must vote for the party that promises you and you trust to fulfill its promises.
But those promises were made in 1994. So the trust of a human being is bound to be stretched to a certain degree. So 25 years later, perhaps one could argue that much more could have been done. And some of the crises that we're seeing in South Africa today would dishearten quite a number of people from participating in this democratic process.
I can't argue against that. I cannot argue against people who say that we've lost the way somewhere over the last 25 years, that we have not got to that sunny upland that we were dreaming of in 94.
Yeah.
But I don't want to talk party politics, and I don't want to say anything that seems to point a finger at anybody in particular. But the fact of the matter is we aren't where we should have been, mm-hmm. we aren't where we could have been, and we are now responsible for voting into office people who will get us where we should be.
I want to talk about something that's current, just very quickly. I know we're going to go to a break very shortly. Judge Kriegle, I mean, you mentioned that it was a very tumultuous time in 1994. But look at 25 years later. You've got things like political killings that are plaguing South Africa, a jostle and a tussle for positions of power.
Yes, yes. And there are, of course, democracy is always jostling for power. The people who kill, the people who use illegal means, are breaching the rules of play of democracy, and that is to be deplored. But we had infinitely more violence, and we had infinitely more competition for support in the run-up to the 94 election. Yes. There's no comparison today.
Yeah. All right, Judge Kriegle, we'll chat again shortly after this break. Let's take a short break here on Unfiltered. We continue our discussion with retired Judge Johann Kriegle when we get back.
Bye. We are making you lose your breath every Friday night with Lip Sync Battle at 6, only on SABC One.
The belt is yours. How do you feel right now?
I feel like a champ. I feel like a real champ.
Welcome back. As we wrap up our discussion very shortly, well, South Africans, of course, will be casting their vote on the 8th of May. What are you hoping to change with your vote? Remember, you may also participate in this conversation on Facebook as well as Twitter using the hashtag SABC News Unfiltered. Let's welcome back, of course, Judge Johann Kriegle. Judge Kriegle, let's take a look at one of these tweets. And this is clearly from a young person who says, that's Insatiable Cass, says, I'm one of the young people who will not be voting. I'm disgruntled, uninspired, and quite disappointed in the way the ruling has handled itself in relation to the interests of the people. They have proven to me that they are not in the business of changing the lives of people, full stop. But wasn't this what 1994 was about? Changing the lives of people, that's what you oversaw.
No. The people must change its lives. The people must run their government. The people must make their government realize that you're not doing what you should be doing. It's a democracy. We can't look to other people to run our country. We must run it. And people who are disenchanted such as that must get on their hind legs. They must go to political meetings. They must say to the political leaders, don't make speeches to me. Produce it. Prove to me that you're going to prove you're going to produce what you promised last time round. It's in our hands, it's in the hands of the voters, not for the leadership to produce this happy country. It's for us to do so. That's democracy.
But it must be quite disheartening, exactly what we've been speaking about some South Africans saying there is no point. That young person believes there's simply no point.
Yes. That young person, I can understand that young person feeling as he or she does. That young person must not put that into some communication like this. That young person should get out on the street, should get his or her colleagues. They must go to their local political party meetings and they should say, we want the following. Are you going to do so? Are you going to produce it? And they must exercise their power as voters to vote into office those whom they believe will give them what they want.
I want to go back to the number of political parties contesting the election. Obviously, a far margin from what we saw in the past. Does this indicate the maturity of South Africa's democracy and perhaps, that there's an attitude from the electorate that there's an ability to organize outside of the mainstream political parties?
That's the one interpretation you can put on it. My own interpretation is that there's a disenchantment with the political parties, there's a disappointment. Generally, the electorate are no longer prepared to put their trust only in the big, major, known political parties. They are
29 is a large number.
It's an uncomfortably large number.
Why do you say uncomfortable?
It's because the ballot paper is too big. Counting the ballots is going to be much more difficult. The large number of political parties is an administrative nuisance. But it's the people's right and it's the party's right. People who want to put up the deposit and stand for election, fine. On our electoral system, no votes are wasted. Yeah. Every single little party participates in the national election, and if you get the minimum number of votes, you can get a seat in parliament. You get two, you can get three. We may be heading for alliance politics in future. Not a bad idea. In fact, for a country such as ours, the local government elections have shown that in Johannesburg and Pretoria, Port Elizabeth, alliances work, provided politicians realize that it's their job to produce the goods.
But does it show the maturity of our democracy?
It shows a maturing. We've got a long way to go to maturity.
What do you think is the real threat to that democracy? If we look at 1994 and to where we are today, there's much to be celebrated, as you indicated, in this democracy. But of course, there's still a long way to go. Many would argue that. What is the real threat to that democracy, to that X that was put on that ballot paper 25 years ago?
I think the real threat is a socio-economic and not a political one. I think the real threat is the large number of unemployed people, large number of people who are not only unemployed, but unemployable. Mm. There I see is our major problem, and that I think is the biggest challenge to be faced by the government that we're going to be electing.
Let's take another tweet, Judge Kriegle. Obviously, we've got to engage. Thank you so much to Tswanelo Sifoloko, who has tweeted us as well. He says, people know they're right, and I'm sick and tired of the leaders who want us to vote so we can make them rich. Then he mentions a word there. No need, we need proper and legit service delivery. That's exactly what you're speaking about,
yes.
Is the issue pertaining to the socioeconomic conditions of our people. And that, you say, is the real threat to democracy.
Certainly, and it is the job of, for instance, a school management body to rise up and protest loudly if the school lavatories are not in proper order. It is the job and the duty of the local ratepayers in a local authorities area to say, I'm not prepared to put up with the poor service that is being delivered. Go to your local MP, go to your local municipal representative and say, Pelile Daba, I don't want to talk anymore. You're not delivering the goods. I'm going to vote against you next time.
Let me ask you a final question, Judge Kriegle. Does it disappoint you, the current state of the country? I mean, yes, you were the IEC chairperson back then, but you saw the hopes and aspirations of the people. And here we are 25 years later, sitting with our own. Are you disappointed at all by the state?
Yes, I am. I'm saddened by it. We are not where we could and should have been. We're certainly not where we hoped in 1994 we would be. We're not where the people who fought and died for liberation thought we would be 25 years after the arrival of democracy in South Africa.
And that's a good way to end it. Thank you so much for your time. Retired Judge Johann Kriegle, who was the chairperson of the IEC in 1994 when South Africans went to cast their ballots in that historic election. Well, that's all we have time for in Unfiltered. Thank you so much for joining us on the Sunday evening. You have a great week ahead. We'll see you again next week, Sunday. Good night.